What we're going to look at today is how to optimize an image for the web in Adobe Fireworks. And what you see on the workspace right now is a banner image. It's 1024 pixels wide. And what we're going to do is take a look at the optimization inside of Fireworks. And if you don't know why we're optimizing images, it's important because not everybody has high-speed bandwidth when they connect to the internet. So what we're doing is we're reducing the cost of downloading images. So the amount of time it takes to download an image versus the quality of the image. Those two things are going to be inversely proportional. And that's because the file size of the image, usually, you know, the larger the file, the greater the quality of the image. When we start optimizing, we're starting to discard information from the image to make the file smaller on the disk. So as we optimize the image, the quality begins to degrade. So there's a give and take there. The more optimized the image, the smaller the file size is going to be, but the lower the quality of the image is going to be to the viewer. So we're always trying to find a sweet spot between the smallest file size and the best looking image. In Fireworks, to get started, what we're going to do, when we have our image open, we're going to open up the Optimize panel. And if you don't see the Optimize panel when you're looking at Fireworks, what you can do is go to the Window drop-down menu and then select Optimize from the menu, and it'll pull up the same window. And you can optimize a number of different file formats. And they're the common file formats for the web here. You can optimize JPEG, you can optimize PNGs, you can optimize a number of different things. We're concerned with GIFs, JPEGs, and PNGs today. And so last week we talked about why you would want to use JPEGs versus GIFs versus PNGs. And when you are optimizing an image, you're going to optimize with a particular file format in mind. And so if we were working with a photorealistic image, what we would do is optimize our image as a JPEG, normally. If we had an image with large blocks of solid color, which we do here, we would probably try to optimize our image as a GIF. And the same thing goes for PNG too. So many times when you're optimizing an image, GIFs and PNGs are going to give you similar file sizes. Some of the advantages of PNGs though are that you will get better transparency because PNG supports alpha transparency, not just binary transparency that GIFs do. So you can get many different alpha values when you are using transparency in PNGs versus GIFs. But we'll take a look at what that looks like functionally when we're optimizing this particular image. So I'm going to start with JPEG just so you can see the differences between the processes, and you can see the differences in file size too. And so I've selected my export file format. What I'm going to do is move to the left, the upper left-hand side of the screen here, and select a two-up view. And what this is showing me on the left-hand side is my original image, and on the right-hand side, an optimized image preview based on what I've set in the Optimize panel. So as a JPEG, optimized at 86%, my document is 41.55 kilobytes, and somebody on a 56K internet connection would take 6 seconds approximately to download this image. It's not necessarily a bad file size. It's a decent file size. We want to see how small we can get, though. If I reduce this down to 65%, you can see now in my preview image, I start seeing a lot of artifacts being introduced into the image. So my lines aren't as crisp. I start seeing some blown out pixels. My color is not as true. So I don't want to go that far down in quality. If we take a look, I've cut my file size in half almost, but I don't want to sacrifice that type of quality. So what would happen, and I'm going to show what would happen if we switched to GIF. How big would our file be if we worked with GIF target file format? And already I can tell it's going to be relatively big because we're working with 128 color palette right now. and our image already looks banded. So you can see there are bands of color where Fireworks is trying to optimize the gradients in the polygon sky. And our file size, if we look down in the lower corner of the preview window, 37.44K, almost the same size it was at 86% as a JPEG. If we bumped it up to 256 colors, we're still seeing banding, so we're not getting a very good result with GIF at all. I'm going to switch to ping 32, see what we get there. We get better color, but we get a lot better color than we do with GIF. But if we take a look down in the lower corner, you can see our file size is enormous. It's jumped up to 286.56K. So that's not workable. And I'm going to say, even though this is a very geometric image, that JPEG is going to give us the best optimization here. Right now, I am at 87%. I'm going to finesse this maybe down to 80, see what it looks like for us. Depending on the size of your monitor, it's going to be either easier or harder to see your image degrade as you're optimizing. So I recommend that you have the brightness turned up on your screen. I still am seeing here at 85% a little bit of fuzziness, but because this image is so large, I'm going to keep it here and say that 85% optimizing this as a JPEG is going to make me happy. My file size is almost 40K, and so I'm not finished here. What I need to do to save an optimized version of this image is to export this file. So I'm going to go to the File drop-down menu and select Export, and it's going to take all of the settings that are in the Optimize panel and apply them to the image that I'm exporting. And you'll notice here that it is indeed a JPEG, where my original image was a ping. So I'm going to save this where I know I can find it again, under Pics, and I tend to like to save my optimized images as -opt, so I know that the image has been optimized. It's always a good practice to optimize your images once from the original. As you start optimizing your images over and over again, you get this increasing degradation of quality. So always go back to your original image when you're optimizing. I want to point out, while we have this document open, that my original document was a ping, and it was a Fireworks ping. Fireworks pings are different than web pings. A Fireworks ping can contain many different layers, and so I've opened up the layer palette here on the right, and you can see there are a number of vector objects that I've drawn over top of this workspace. And so this is a ping, but technically it's a Fireworks ping. It's much bigger than a regular web ping. And when I optimize this, what's going to happen is that all these layers are going to flatten. Seems intuitive, because when I optimize this, I saved it as a JPEG. But if I were to optimize this image and save it as a ping, a web ping, it would also flatten all of these layers. So they would not be editable any longer. And of course, it would reduce my file size. So really important to keep in mind, Fireworks pings are different than web pings. Fireworks pings support layers, and web pings are flattened images.